Best not to draw attention here.
This was pushed in front of the door.
Shh.
This place is heavily guarded.
No one knows within these walls. Fools return from market trading treasures. Shadows, axe, ready, easy, kill, joy, knowledge. Still. Yep, that is incoherent.
Yeah.
that's the part. Sorry, I'm just trying to... I'm just,
Yes, West where?
La quinta, fra me a slayer.
Calcia mente, mihi mundus, gigant,
mantas, chepan, ohe.
If I find one crack, that statue is as fragile as the rest of my collection and costs more than the hovel you call a home.
Just a clay man with his cock out, you nutter.
Mikkel Ladris, Platten on den Erbenessen, Tinning.
I have a friend who needs that little Roman man you have, Octavian of London.
I've a guess who your friend is, and no. Osbert cannot have his greasy pedestrian fingers on something so exquisite.
Osbert.
Oh, that is delicious. Yes, Osbert. A name fit for a poor failure. It'll cost a cow's weight in silver to get it in his hands.
I'll give you the filthy silver.
Oh. That is... Thank you. Well, I should hope so. You may take the Legionnaire.
Osbert.
And only because you all have such good taste. Now, this one begins a long time ago at a desert oasis, far away, a place of mystery, wonder, and a temple to a hidden god. The guardian of this temple was a proud man, kingly in nature, but not in fact, a protector of holy wisdom. And this protector had a wife, a scholar, who spent her days reading ancient tomes and deciphering the secrets of the desert. Together they had a son, in whom they hoped to instill all their skill and knowledge. The boy was to be a union of their love. But then it came to pass that the king of that land arrived to seize the temple for himself. The protector resisted. In the battle that followed, the boy was killed and the temple was taken. Struck with grief, the protector and the scholar separated.
A king who kills a child is an ergi. They should kill him back.
Indeed. But for a long time, the protector and the scholar followed solitary paths, seeking for a way to revenge their son. But in their isolation, they found only anguish and pain. Alone, they could do nothing but weep and thrash at the fates. After many fruitless years, they came together again to mourn their failure. They embraced as they had in their youth. And in that joining, they realized what was missing. Only the union that had produced their son would lead to their victory. So the protector taught the scholar to fight and ride and seek, while the scholar taught the protector wisdom and deep knowledge. As they trained and studied, they became inseparable, moving, eating, sleeping as one. They were never seen apart. Until one day, they met upon the river's edge. They had learned all they could. Her from him. Him from her. It was here they kissed and separated. She traveled east, he west. They were never seen again. It is said, however, that once every year, two eagles would return to that very spot to linger and look upon the sea. The people of the region like to see these eagles, for they are an omen, a symbol of protection.
They turned into birds, like Loki became a salmon.
Perhaps. Still, others say that the eagles were their children, born of a love that could never endure. But who is to say for sure?
Seems like
Octavian, I have something that may interest you.
Hmm?
Maximilian sends his regards.
What? He gave this to you? That perfect little wretch. How did he bring himself to part with it?
Ask no questions. Hear no lies. I only hope you enjoy it, and that neither of us have to see that man again.
Oh, thank you, Eivor. Thank you.
I must be on my way now. Goodbye.
Dai dulci fruamini!
There'll be bits of you all over!
Yeah.
you yet!
Perfectly good swords into the river. Bend them all out of shape. Reason to, or I'd have fished them out.
I draw the line when they start.
Such a simple thing would be just forgotten. Who knew they would think somebody would be incapable of aiming and dodging at the same time? What a alien concept that must be. Smoke grenades.